to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everyone, for coming this evening. First item on the agenda, approval of the minutes of the December 3rd business session. Hopefully you had a chance to review.
Motion approved.
I'll second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Public comments? Committee reports, admin and finance. I apologize, I went through them, but we're up $4,000 total from where we were last meeting, but I don't remember what the total was, but the direction was right. Step was not big, but at least it was good, so. And I did have a question, Joe, on, I know you and I had spoken on the, and again, kudos to the folks getting that water line fixed under the highway out there. One of the things that was brought up was if you're not a, and I mean, there's always going to be somebody we can't reach, but one of the questions was, if I don't have a cell phone, I can't text, and I don't have a computer, so I don't do email or Facebook, how do you get ahold of me? And the question was on the public access on Channel 7 on Comcast, and I know we had an issue with the computer, is there any update on where that?
Yeah, he actually got through the Comcast finally, and we got it going, kind of, we got the new computer in. The problem is Comcast don't even, so they don't even talk to you about it, and you try calling for help, they just like, hey, we don't know, but. So we ended up finally getting hold of the converter company that made actually the converter box from the Comcast that goes into the feed. And we got hold of him, and they gave us some ideas. Anyway, long story short, he's got a new used computer that he's got set up, that he's got changed the video graphic card to allow it to hook up to the converter. And once that done, his Channel 7 should be running. He ordered it on Tuesday, or Wednesday. Supposed to be here by Monday, and Tuesday he's supposed to be putting in, so. But if that doesn't work, then they told us that converter is bad, and we would have to send it back to the original company, and they would fix it and send it back to us. But it's going through that third-party converter company rather than Comcast, and Comcast would not even touch it anymore.
And I just got to thinking, setting here was, when you say that was, would it be possible then to at some point run the most recent meeting, you know, have that run on that channel once a day, twice a day, or whatever?
Yeah, I would have to give it, I could give it five. Yes, yeah.
So that would, if you don't have a computer, you can't pull it off of YouTube, but if you're telling me I do have cable TV, okay, well now you can still watch the meeting on the TV, and you could, and then the crawl would have a boiler.
Yeah, I know, other cities do that, so I'll just check what I say, because right now, ours is just a PowerPoint presentation. That's what slides do, and I'm sure there's a way, I just have to figure it out, but yeah, that'd be great. And like I said, the other way is we do notify all the local news stations and all the radio stations. I know for that Channel 5 news had it on, I didn't see it there on 9 or 4, 5 minutes left on.
Thank you. Public Health and Safety Committee, anything to report? Park Board, anything to report? Planning and zoning?
Nope.
Public Works?
I got some things to report. In your packet, you see some information that Cody Buzz, has asked for in the past. You see two proposals for slide making machines. The one is listed as Capico. They'll pick out a price that's $24,000, it's like six machines that they quoted that individually, and they added them all together. But, you know, like a 38 track cutter is $5,995, and you go buy a software package with another $1,600. And then the other one I got was from Midwest Signs, and for the whole complete setup, it's $2,818.03. That's a smaller version. The most it cuts out are 26-inch letters, which would do street signs fine, and would be like, you know, informational signs, like stop signs and stuff like that. So that's just for information only. And then the other one I did at the last week, I told contractor to come out and look at South Hudson Street and just see what the contractor would cost to do that work. And that's in the packet too, and it's going to be $30,000.
$34,000?
Yeah. Yeah, $32,500. And that was just for information only too.
And you said we could do it, your estimate was 15, right?
Yeah, 15.
And roughly 2 weeks for it to work.
But my estimate don't include labor, because my guys will be working, they're paying one, so, yeah. And then, what you brought up, you know, the water main break on Route 24 highway. We got, then we had hired a contractor to help us. Right now, we look at a cost of about $30,000, fixed it, net includes materials and overtime and stuff like that. And with all long ago, we expected we had to do lots of problems, as you can imagine. So, that's what we're looking at on that one.
Kind of wanted to say, when I looked at the accounts, that the water sewer fund was $154,000, right around there, so.
Which is a.
There's money in that account.
I mean, we saved a lot of money, because, you know, we would have got a, we hired Bill Google to come help us, because they own that big machine, because we literally had to push that pipe underneath 24 highway. And, you know, if we would have hired a bigger con, a truck company like FEMA or Redford, we would probably look at $70,000 to $100,000 to do that project.
That golden rule out of that?
Oh, yes, I said, which?
Yeah, I think under Silver Road or something, but yeah, okay. Good people.
In other words, local people, I saw just looking at Facebook commenting on family members that were working on getting the water back up. I think there should be some long-term payback on that too, because when they found it, because you could see the water, the creek was running stronger downstream from where, and that kind of tipped off the leak, and so.
That had to rain.
Check the meter.
We was losing 403 gallons a minute from that leak.
How much?
403 gallons a minute.
Woo!
All going into 24 highway and hitting this little creek and going straight to.
You can't do that at a car.
Yeah, and it's been leaking for a while, and as that close second half of the bottom, it was just gone, so. So that's going to help out, I mean, that's due to our water losses.
Great.
Fairs and festival? All right, we got some old business here, the burning ordinance, we'd asked them to prepare something for it. I think we got some, I know there's another iteration of this.
Yeah, it's on a separate sheet.
This afternoon.
Yeah, so, yeah, the latest one that I got is on a separate sheet.
It looks like one has a time of 10 a.m. and 3:30 p.m., and the other one says sunrise.
Yeah, the sunrise is the updated one.
Yeah, the one by itself is the updated one.
Yeah, is that the only thing that's changed from the one?
That's not it, it's, it's been asked if you change, that's why I brought to you this one, you guys can decide what you like, don't like, or, and the next one, I'll be next to the ordinance board.
I think it's pretty well written, pretty well states what I feel pretty good.
Yeah, I would like something under section, I guess, after, I guess we set, it'd just be add a letter F. Just that we exempted recreational fires and some of the other things, and to say that lots greater than 2.5 acres shall not be affected by this ordinance.
Okay, was that good?
Lots greater than 2.5 acres.
I got mine. Yeah, I mean, just, yeah, and I talked to the attorney about just how you manage land on a postage stamp versus larger things, but there's stuff like that.
About 50 lots.
Did you say 200?
Yeah, I don't have a garden that goes that'll reach in the back of my yard.
Two and a half acres.
Shall not be affected by this ordinance.
Well, I went down and spoke with the fire chief, so I thought we should get an expert's opinion. And in my discussions with him, one I got, and again, he's not here, so I don't want to speak for him, but my takeaway was, basically, he didn't want to get involved in the nuts and bolts of how and why to do stuff, but we do need to let him know, it'd be good once we do approve something. And then in the discussions, he didn't really seem, my takeaway was, he didn't seem too concerned, for the most part, about like recreational fires and stuff, so, therefore, I wouldn't be too concerned.
Well, I think if I were going to burn, I think I'd let the department know
question, and I don't know if you have this answer. Do we know how much we paid the attorney to write this?
I want to see that in the next one, so.
Okay. Will you present that to the board?
Sure.
I think it's key for us to know how much we're paying for each ordinance and each thing that we do with the taxpayers' dollars.
Do we have a liaison between us and the Fire Protection District? Because like their webpage is wrong, it says we still require a permit from the DNR, which obviously doesn't exist anymore, so we can tell them, hey, your website's wrong, and we're trying to get ours in line with the actual rules and regs.
I don't, I mean, other than just, I think, you know, any of us and Joe, that know as far as the formal structure, that's up now with the chief and everything.
Because I noticed that the, in this, when it's the, several times the fire chief is referenced, C4 and 5, they'll say, code officer is the fire chief.
And it appears what the attorney did basically was cut pace from Oak Grove.
I assume as much, yeah.
And it's word for word, even the italics, everything is identical, just a few subtractions.
Because, for example, one other example, look at this way. On E, where it says, according to the guidelines of the National Fire Code, Article 2, Division 11, I think it'd be nice to have a link there to that actual code so people don't know what was left.
Yeah. And I don't know if any of you guys went and looked at those. That's a doozy. It's like a 600-page
thing. Oh, I'm sure it is.
International Fire Code.
We got
it. Yeah, it's exciting to read.
Yeah, when I saw the size, I knew it was close.
Yeah. But yeah, I don't know. I'm sure it's kind of a legal catch-all, but I don't know how A, citizens are going to be able to read that and understand what it means.
Right.
Or if all of our police officers are trained on the International Fire Code regulations. But I'm assuming it's probably just a legal catch-all.
And I guess the other question is, you know, does the current ordinance we have, is there substantial problems with, you know, the chief's not concerned with that we've got a problem, are we just looking to fix something that nobody really cares about?
Right. Yeah, that would be mine. I do like having specific things like this. I think that's fine, taking what these other cities have already done.
Then it might be worth just having to strike the fire chief, because again, if you're in Oak Grove or some of the other towns, the fire department's under the city. Mm-hmm. But because our fire district is separate from.
Yeah, that's what they need to bring that up.
Might be
they're not under our umbrella.
Change some of those little things.
Do you want to strike fire chief?
Yeah, I mean, we don't have really any authority over him or her. In this case, you know.
What else?
And then maybe strike that reference to the International Fire Code, just for the one you said.
Who knows what that is?
Yeah, I mean, we don't seem to have a massive problem around this.
So that there's no time period for recreational fires?
I think you did pretty much run that.
Yeah.
How do we decide on 3:30 being?
That was in somebody else's ordinance, I don't know.
Okay, because it seemed like if I can hold work in the summer and it's dark until, you know, 8:30, 9 o'clock, and I got leaves burned, I'm not home before 3:30.
So as far as burning leaves like they do out on the edge of the roads and stuff like that, that's going to be prohibited?
Yeah, they have to be in a container.
Yeah, or on a lot larger than 2.5 acres.
Or that.
Well, I mean, I'm just asking, has that been an issue for people?
That's what I don't.
I mean, if it hasn't been an issue, why are we changing it?
It seemed to me like it was more of a safety thing. You know, if you've got a leaves out front, it's a little bit windy. Fires can get out of control worse. You've got to set
up. You can create quite a bit of smoke if you burn that along the street.
Yeah, if you have a smaller container.
To a car coming by. Not that really good out there.
No, me too. What else would I like to ask you?
So do you want to change that 3:30 date if it's fine, or what?
30 minutes prior to sunset.
Yeah, I was going to say, I was thinking like an hour or 30 minutes prior to sunset, yeah.
Really, the sunrise, sunsets when the winds are calmest.
Yep, absolutely.
The 30 minutes or an hour, you know?
tell you, I manage it with a rake and a shovel, that's how I do it.
So you'd have to have a hell of a gun to hold from where you're.
He got a heck of a string on in that 50-foot hose.
But 2 acres of things up from all this?
It is, but I just, I mean, I think you, I do better staying on it with rake.
Yeah, I do too.
What have you, than I do kind of spray over the garden hose.
So you want to like it on the ground?
The water burn.
Let's see, what was the other one? On E, works on the size of the fire. Four wide, four length, four high. I mean, I'm assuming that's the combustible material, not the size of the flame. It says recreational fires are restricted to.
Cause how tall is your gizmo? It's pretty cool. I said, I'd say it's more than 4 feet. He has a, one of those outdoor, oh, what you call it, but it's a.
Propane.
Yeah, but it's gonna have a flame that's 6 feet high.
Well, and some bonfires exceed that, I don't know if we need to. I don't think we need to put those restrictions on that. I really don't.
You can just strike the deal together.
Yeah, I don't want to see someone out there with a tent measure trying to get close to fire.
Exactly, I don't see any reason for that.
Yeah, I think like you guys said, just strike a deal altogether.
I'll deal with that. Any other questions regarding the burn ordinance? Now we'll move on to the discussion of the phone system. We talked about a little bit earlier, just getting some pricing information on looking at voice over internet versus the old fashioned box lines that we have now, because there's an issue around our switch and what that is, the ability of that, ability to get it to a proper modern system. So Joe's done the legwork on that.
This all stems because early this week, on Monday and Tuesday, we had a phone call where we could not call out, nobody could call into City Hall. And so we've got fast communication out here, and Eric got in, they got it going again, but the system we've got is brought here from the old City Hall. That's one on Washington, the one up on 24. So it's aggregated. And in fact, he said, Kyle, that's on the fast communication, said if it goes down, he's going to get one of those for it. So, that got us looking at doing voice over internet phone service. And we got, and like I said, I just got this just for information purposes, see which way you guys even want to go. We got Bats, is our current one. And but they got this set up as you pay $426.41 down, and that leases out all the phones. And then your monthly charge would be $236 a month. Then the other one, which is that spine, the SIP spine, it's a one-time cost of $950, and that could be shortened down by another $200, but we don't think we're going to need that router, so just in case we put that in that price, so it could go down $750. It's a one-time purchase, you own the phones flat out, and your monthly service fee would be $180.65.
I would like to recommend that we contact Comcast and see how much it would cost to have VoIP added to our current Comcast service and compare prices.
And the service fees that for either one of these, that'll include any kind of IP issues that they may have, you know, be able to train and all that kind of stuff.
Now, I will tell you this, these folks already got their voice over here going to back because they had something go down. And that's one of the bids. It's like in the process of being done because right now when they have to dispatch, in Jackson County, they close at night. They only got a transfer phone. A lot of times they don't transfer over, so when people call, they get over. This will automatically transfer the phones over to dispatch for. But what you did a couple months ago, the order is no contractors, and it's actually saved us money. That's why we did it. But we just look at City Hall side now.
So they put like, that's what they have, a log adapter on the board.
Okay.
So like I said, they could have just went and bought the phone, no one, put a lease program, they did a toothpaste expense, you paid 2 cents for a phone, or you can upgrade.
I can't say whether it's a good number or a bad number, but this, by this, these numbers match what we just did phones in one of our clinics a couple, well, last week. And these numbers look very similar to what we paid up there, within $5 or so for line items. So either we both get our getting hoes or.
Perfect figure.
What kind of term, like, installation time are they looking at? I mean, is that curiosity?
Well, it's if I didn't give us time, like I said, this is discussion only.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
I know Bass was looking at it 2 weeks, by the time they go to the phones, they get the phones in, they program at Bass before they bring them out here and pick them out.
And do you know, did they price these, there's some that they can do with the wireless, the, what would you call them, the access ports or whatever the things, that some of them you can do with wireless, or do they have to be hardwired?
We don't have routers?
No, the phones, like the ones we have at the hospital have to be plugged in.
Yeah.
But they do make ones that don't have to be.
Yeah, these are the ones that plug in.
You do have that power supply to them, but.
Yeah.
So we should continue to pursue and get more details?
Yes, please.
Okay.
All right, elected officials comment?
Okay, fine.
Fire away.
All right. First off, Joe, thank you for sharing the photos that you guys have, whoever was sharing them, thank you on Facebook with the street cleaning out here, it looked really good. And also some ditch cleaning out there on the, in the Ward 2 area, that's greatly appreciated. Is that an ongoing project with the clearing out? I know we got that creek over there that has trees about yay big in it. The creek off of Dale.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's totally up to you guys, but the only reason that we cleaned that one behind North Hudson is because that is actually on city-owned property, so we just clean out the ditches on our property. The problem is, if you start cleaning up private people's ditches, you clean out all of them, which is fine, that's what the board chooses to do.
Who'd you say that belonged to? Again, I didn't hear that.
That's right.
The creek, the fire, you said fire prairie?
The one that, that belongs to.
So it's the Dale.
Yeah, that's our property, that's on our property, that's why we can go in and clean out any time, because it's on our property.
But the one I was just talking about, the one on Dale?
It belongs to, I looked it up today, the film's a big field side that's to the east of it.
But it's not the city property.
No, it's not the city property at all, and we don't have access to it, that's where you get in trouble with, we don't have access to this, you know.
Is that the side farm?
No, let's talk about the east of the town.
Oh, okay.
Like there's like the camp shop, old Lexington. Because, yeah, I did get a comment from somebody from Dale that said, well, we cleaned up the one on Dale Street, not Dale, sorry, Cooper, 103 Cooper. But that's privately owned. I mean, you guys want us to start doing privately ditches, we can.
Right, yeah.
That's what we're doing, that one got done, so like I said, it's on city property.
Okay. What about the Billings Farm? I don't know if anybody's heard anything back from them. Are they going to do, is he going to do the farming?
Yeah, I just talked to him last week. And he's still.
He's going to get good? Okay. And then also from tonight, thanks for the sign information. The sign stuff, the sign info, the fact that I appreciate you calling up on that. That's all I heard.
I just got a little bit.
Sure.
If you guys don't know, election coming up in April. I believe there's 4 aldermen this round that are due, so you can turn your packets in now. Or if there's anybody out there that wants to run, it's open. Joe probably got all the packets and information, see him. I think that ends January 19th is what you have to get in on your information. So, and then I was gonna ask the chief about an update on the car to see, getting decals and stuff, but.
Captain Mike,
if we had any information where we're at on that, I was just curious.
Yeah, I'm getting the Durango outfit.
Mm-hmm.
We are scheduled for, I believe, January 11th. They were backward, of course, like everything with COVID, and also the Durango being pretty new police car, a lot of parts were still being outfitted for that. So we do have a day scheduled in January. Hopefully by the end of January, we'll see it on the road.
Awesome, thank you.
Good morning. Well, two things. One, kind of a sad note. I don't know how many of you know, but Father Kaiser passed away this week, on the 11th, I believe it was. And you know, he was, to me, an institution around here. I remember I was not even old enough to drive when he took over here. We kind of had the priest of the month, and now Father Kaiser came, and for 40-plus years, we've had a steady priest here in town, so I don't know what the diocese is going to do, but I know he was engaged in a lot of things around town. I know he'd be missed, and so keep his family and his parish family in your prayers. Don't have anything definitive, but I do want to, see Tony here reminded me, with Levin Buckner, through connections with Tony, has had an opportunity to possibly acquire some fairly nice water features for a potential spray park. So we were getting insurance pricing on that. It's probably going to be about $500 a month for insurance. Still getting pricing on what it would take to relocate and set up. But these were coming out of Schlitterbahn with about a 40-foot long train that had multiple water features. And there was a, looked like a pirate ship. And I think these things look cool in the park, even if they didn't have the water features, but just still trying to chase down what all the costs on this are going to be, because I don't want to be getting a free puppy, but you got to buy dog food and get shots and all that stuff. So just trying to figure out where we're at on the price side, but that's something that hopefully we'll be getting back with y'all here just a little bit to see how to move forward on that. But I think it'd be nice to nice to offer to the citizens to have some improvements in the park. I think we got a nice park, but we can make it better. So that's all I've got.